My name is Madueke Basir. I am from Ezeagu local government area in Enugu State. This is the third time Mr. JJ Emejuru has destroyed my property. And I have all the evidence and all the pictures and cameras to back my complaint. So I call upon the government, to the federal government, to take the immediate action, because I demand that this very man will pay for the damage he caused me in this very building. It is not only me. He destroyed many properties in this area, which I can take you around to see the properties he has destroyed, with 30 boys, which is his thugs, which I know one of them, called Biggie. They stole all our properties, all our belongings, and they made away with so many things in our house. So I want the government to take action of this. The man is demanding 15 million naira per each plot, as he claims to be the owner of this property. But I bought this property from the company called the Best Shelter, and they gave me the seat, and I have every document that cover up the very property. But this man has been terrorizing me in this very building, and he has broke this house. This is the three times he has come with the bulldozer to bring down the building. And he told us that he cannot rest until he get this whole building down, because even all these properties belong to him. He said that he has 400 plots of land in this very building, including the airport lands. So I can take you to the house. He came with almost 30 thugs to destroy both the windows of my building and everything, and they vowed to bring down this very house, because they told me that I have nobody to speak to me. This is one of the windows the man has destroyed in my building. Look at this. I will take you up there. The first time he came, he demanded 50 million naira from me. Even one of the top demanded 200,000, that I should pay the money immediately in his account. I will take you upstairs to show you more of the damages. I want to show you one of them. This is one of the flats. Look at the windows. He destroyed. JJ, Mr. JJ Emeduo, with his talk. This is what they did in my house. So I need, I want government to help me to restore my properties, and I must pay me money for all the control in my house. There is no look at all what they did in my house. The washroom, come close here. Look at what they did in my house. I have. Look at what they did. They break here, because the guy in person, he came with his voice. He said that I should pay him 15 million naira before he let me be in my own property. I have the receipt, and I have every evidence to back my...
Okay, my name is Mr. Joshua Akachukwu Otu. So I'm one of the landlords here. I own one of the first three buildings in Dora Street, just directly opposite to this street. So on Wednesday, as we're just waking up in the morning, around 10, should be between 10 to 11 a.m. in the morning, we started seeing bulldozers coming around also alongside. So, and Immediately we start seeing, we saw the man called JJ immediately in the midst of the fleet of policemen. And he was directing bulldozer to start demolishing building. They started from demolishing the airport fence. So after that, he commanded the payloader to go straight to my own property to demolish. He was seriously pointing at my fence and asking the bulldozer to bulldoze, to bulldoze. He came with a lot of thugs. Thugs from the street that came with a, what do you say, hammer?
Axe.
They first of all broke my light, my fence light, before the bulldozer came to tamper with my fence.
My name is Obiora Kingsley, and I'm a tenant in the apartment that was broken down 2 days ago by JJ Emejulu. In that fateful morning, I was just upstairs, and the next thing I saw was crowd coming to the compound and bulldozing down the fence. So it was just overwhelming what was happening, and before I knew it, they broke into my apartment and started taking my properties, that are demolishing the building at that moment. So it was just me in the apartment, and before I could understand what was happening, they made away with virtually all my properties, and that was how it was before the police came around and they started negotiating, and it was stopped for the time. But at that point, the problems have already gone away with most of my properties.